Good day and welcome back. We'll talk about polarization. We learn about the things happen in polarizations, which is obtained by polarizer or by reflection. First, let us define the polarization. It is a phenomenon where the oscillation of a wave is limited to one plane. So this only applies to the transverse wave since the vibration of particle is perpendicular to the wave propagation. Light is an electromagnetic wave which consists of electric and magnetic field variating in two perpendicular axes. They could be in any direction. When you apply the polarizer, you can resolve the light wave into two components. One is parallel and another is perpendicular to the polarizing axis of the polarizer. So what happens is the perpendicular component will be absorbed by the polarizer, or you can also say it is blocked by the polarizer. Polarizer only allow those who parallel to its polarizing axis to pass through. Hence, the intensity of light is halved, although the amplitude is unchanged. From here, we have the intensity is equal to half of the original intensity. And if we rotate the polarizer, it is still constant all the time. Next thing is when we apply polarizer on the polarized light. So now the incident light to the second polarizer is vibrating in only one plane. The first effect is that the amplitude will change. It is equal to A cos theta, which depends on the angle between the vibration of light and the polarizing axis. So the intensity of light is proportional to the square of amplitude. We can apply the ratio and we can get the equation of I2 equal to I1 cos square theta, which is also the Malus law. Based on the equation, the intensity of light depends on the angle of rotation. So it will not be constant like the previous case when we apply the polarizer on the unpolarized light. So let's review the phenomenon again by looking at past year in 2016. A beam of non-polarized light passes through two polarizers. The angle between the polarizing axis of the polarizers is 30 degrees. Here is the recap. First, we have the original intensity of the unpolarized light is I0. After passing through the first polarizer, the vibration of wave is limited to one plane only, where the perpendicular component is absorbed by the polarizer. Hence, the intensity is half, where I1 is equal to 1 over 2 I0. Next, we apply the polarizer on the polarized light. Based on Malus law, the output intensity is the input intensity multiplied cos squared theta. If we want to relate back to the original intensity, just substitute the equation of I1 is equal to 1 over 2 I0. The rest is just calculation. We can obtain the final intensity of light is 0.375 of original intensity. So this is something interesting. Question asks for the percentage of light absorbed by both polarizers. The first polarizer definitely absorbed 50% of the intensity, while the second polarizer in this case will absorb another 12.5% of the original intensity. So there will be a total of 62.5% absorbed by both the polarizer. So the answer is C for this question. We shall look at another question from KOLEJ TINGKATAN ENAM PETALING JAYA. We just do a quick through. It mentioned the polarizer P and Q are rotated at an angle theta and 3 theta. So we look back the definition and the derivation. The angle in the equation is the angle between the vibration axis of light and the polarizing axis. Therefore, the equation here is a little bit different, but apply for this case. It is the IQ equal to IP cos square 2 theta. We focus on the third question. If the intensity of the plane polarized light beam transmitted by Q is 1 over 6 I0, determine the value of theta. It refers back to the original intensity. What we can do is just put in the equation that IP is half of original intensity. So this would be the overall equation for two polarizer. IQ need to be 1 over 6 I0. Just put in the equation and solve it. The angle theta here is 27.4 degrees. Now we look at one last topic, which is about the polarization by reflection. We learned that when light incidence on the surface of a medium, it will be partially reflected and refracted. Based on Brewster's law, both of them will be fully plane polarized if the incident angle satisfies the equation tangent I equal to n, else they are only partially plane polarized. So this is the diagram to illustrate the Brewster's law. From Snell's law, n is equal to sine I over sine r. Combined with the Brewster law, we can see that sine I is equal to cos I, which is the corresponding angle that I plus R is 90 degrees. So you can observe both the reflected and refracted ray is perpendicular to each other when they are fully plane polarized. Let's go back to the trial question just now, question 19C. When non-polarized light beam incidence onto a glass plate at an angle of 30 degrees, the light is partially refracted into the glass at an angle of 19 degrees. So why the question tell you about this information? We are given with the incident angle and the refracted angle, so we can apply the Snell law to get the refractive index of the medium. Then we can apply Brewster law to determine the Brewster angle so that the light is fully plane polarized. Just apply the equation, you can get the answer is 56.9 degree. For the refracted angle, you also can get it by 90 degree minus 56.9 equal to 33.1 degree. So that's all for my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Thank you.